Good morning students, here I am explaining you chapter 2, types of computers. So on the basis of the signals, there are the three types of computers. They are analog computers, digital computers and hybrid computers. So what is an analog computer? Analog computer is used for computing continuous range of values. The result given by analog computer will be approximately, since they deal with quantities that vary continuously. In generally deals with the physical variables such as voltage, pressure, temperature, speed. So analog computers are mostly used in hospital. Now what is the digital computer? On the other hand, digital computers are used for perform the calculation works. It uses binary numbers system in which they are only two digits 0 and 1. Each number is called bit. Digital computers can give more accurate and faster results. Digital computers is well suited for solving complex problems in engineering and technologies. Third one is hybrid computer. A hybrid computer, it is a combination of analog computer and digital computer. So it provides both the facility, analog computer and digital computer. So on the basis of signals, computers are three types: analog computer, digital computer and hardware computer. Analog computers are used for calculate the physical quantity and they gives the results, analog results, in the continuously form. Mostly this computer used to compute the voltage, pressure, temperature, speed, etc. These computer mostly used in hospitals to measure the heartbeat of a person, whereas digital computers are used to perform the digital tasks such as calculations. They uses the binary numbers, and digital computer will also gives the fast result as compared to analog computer, where we require the analog work and digital work. So will we use the hybrid computer for that purpose. Now the next category, computer based on their performance and storage capacity. So based on the performance and storage capacity, there are the four types of computers. These are supercomputer, mainframe computer, mini computer and microcomputer. Now this is the diagram of supercomputer. So what do you mean by supercomputer? When we talk about these types of computers, the first type that comes to our mind would be a supercomputer. They are best in terms of processing capability and also the most expensive one. These computers can process billions of instructions per second. Normally, they will be used for applications where required intensive numerical computations such as stock analysis, weather forecasting, etc. On the other hand, supercomputers are used for scientific simulations, graphics, fluid dynamic calculations, nuclear energy, etc. The cost of supercomputer mostly comes in crores, 5 to 7 crores approximately. Now, next type of computer, that computer is mainframe computer. Mainframe computers are used in small organizations such as VHEL, universities, government colleges, etc. They have greater power calculation, so mostly Multiple programs can be executed on these computers simultaneously. So the major difference between the supercomputer and mainframe computer is supercomputer can perform a single calculation in less time, whereas mainframe computers can perform multiple calculations simultaneously. Mainframe computers are also used in banking server, airlines and railway reservation, etc. Mainframe computers can provide the services to 1000 to 3000 computers. Next category of digital computer is mini computers. Mini computer are also similar to a mainframe computer, and they are used for as a server for the users, 100 to 200 users. This is the diagram of mini computer. So the mostly use for a mini computer is making a server where we want to provide the services for the computers from 50 to 200 computers. And the last category of computer is microcomputer. Mostly these computers we are using in our real life. This is the diagram of microcomputer. Microcomputer can be a laptop or a desktop computer. They are cheaper as compared to mini computers, because mini computer can have multiple processors, whereas microcomputer mostly have a single processor chip on motherboard. There are further classified into desktop computers, laptop computers and handheld computers. Handheld computers are also called the PDAs. Now, this is the diagram of desktop computer, and mostly desktop computer are used nowadays in the organization such as schools, offices, etc. Another category of microcomputer is laptop. The basic difference between a desktop and a laptop is laptop is similar to a desktop computer, but it has a one advantage for portability. And the last types of computer of digital is handheld computer. So handheld computers are the type is also a microcomputers, and these are mostly used for scheduling appointments, storing addresses and playing games with the help of stylus, just like a pen, and we can also do the work from the finger because these computers mostly have touch screen. Nowadays, handheld computers are the smartphone.